Yeah, we back up in this. Y'all already know. Cause I am the baddest of them all. If you ain't about money, then I don't mess with y'all. Y'all think I don't get girls, cause I ain't very tall. If she see my stacks, I bet you.
You kept on requesting this, so here it is. It's the 2010 psychotic killer tire movie, Rubber. Directed by Quentin Dupleux and starring no one you know. Now, this is a French, independent, English-speaking film, which explains a lot. This, quote, movie tries so hard to be meta and lampoon the entire horror genre, but it just fails completely to accomplish that goal and instead delivers this brain cell-destroying, unwatchable trash. French people, man. Because when I say meta, I am referring to this. The movie's opening scene and its overall framing. Now, similar to how Alfred Hitchcock would begin his movies with an introductory on-screen statement, Rubber begins with an actor playing a narrator describing the movie we are about to see, and then it goes as far as having a group of other actors playing an audience who come up to witness this film with the narrator all the way to the point that they are handed binoculars to watch the movie. I mean, okay, first off, you made a killer tire movie. That in and of itself is meta and strangely comedic enough. You didn't need this attempted avant-garde introduction with these in-movie audience segments. It is just so jarring and off-putting. Now, what they should have done is just started the movie at the dump where Robert the Tire comes alive and starts exploding stuff with his newfound telekinetic psionic brain powers. I mean, why go through the effort of explaining to us that we're seeing a bizarre movie when that is your opening scene? So anyway, Robert rolls out the dump, dude, and he goes out onto a road. Now, once he's there, a woman in a car is passing by, dude, and he almost kills her. He almost gets her, man, but she gets away. Now, this starts the generalized, I guess, plot of this movie, which is Robert the Tire trying to hunt down this woman and kill her until the movie winds up, and it is just so anticlimactic. I mean, that's all there is to say about this film's storyline. This movie is so mind-numbingly stupid, I can't even use a more advanced adjective than just pure dumb. Now, I understand the appeal here, obviously. Some people just love so bad they are good movies, like The Room or Troll 2, and I get that. Also, people just love low-budget horror that simply is based around insane kills. But there are some people who actually feel this film accomplishes its goal of being a hip, highbrow parody of the aforementioned splatter genre. Now, me? I don't agree with any of that, dude. I want my time back for having been talked into watching and having to review this travesty against film itself. This movie is a crime. It's just bad, bad. You can only laugh at it, never with it. And to conclude, it's only worth watching if you are a cinephile completionist who must witness for yourself the worst movies of all time, of which this belongs on any list. 0 stars.